So I told you that how do you, you mentioned, madam, the differentiation, product differentiation. Now that's a very interesting. How do I differentiate if I'm in the business of selling bottled water? How do I differentiate? Will you buy this for more money because the cap is different? Because differentiation means I want more money for the same water. For the same bottle. That's right? Cutting it down, maybe a marketing class for many, many other things. But product differentiation means that for the same commodity, I want a better price. In fact, I don't want it to be called a commodity.
Will that have minerals?
Will that have minerals? Will you pay more?
With branding.
With branding? Yeah. So what is the brand telling you?
Quality.
It might give me some quality. So if I call it Chingua, yeah, will you buy it? Chingua added minerals? No? If I call it Mobla, it has a better chance than Chingua, right? Why? The Mobla is an established pen, it's not in water. How do I create that in water? I'm DEKI and I want to sell DEKI water and I want to compete with Mobla. How do I do that? Only with two ways, in my opinion. I first try to understand what is it that that customer wants. Right? Which means that the water, bottled water that is given to me here as a visiting person, it's a certain, and Bisleri is perfectly okay for that. But if I were, let's say, the Prime Minister of India, coming to give a lecture at this, would I still be served the same water? May or may not be. If you had kids at home, young, newborn kid, would you still use the same bottled water? Would you use Jingwa? I say, no, yeah, this sounds Chinese, I don't want to take a chance with this little baby. Yeah, no fault of Jingwa, you might have been a Buddha for all I care. So that product differentiation actually stems from who it is being sold. A large hotel which uses 20,000 bottles a day for all the delegates that come to their conferences. Their customer value, they also want clean water, they also want a good bottle. But their value for, the reason to buy a bottle might be very different. I want bottles that can be disposed of easily because I have 20,000 many bottles to sell to dispose every day. In today's context, if somebody came with a biodegradable bottle, it would sell much more. Because today the overall discussion is a lot about environment, global warming, saving the planet. 20 years ago, nobody cared. 20 years ago, your parents were probably saving a bottle like this. Saying, "Abhi pani khatam ho gaya, abhi isme thoda tel daal ke rakhe." Right? That context has moved. This product differentiation context has to move. The values will change. I could be a shirt maker, just a white shirt maker. But I have to decide, do I want to sell white shirts to students at MDM? Do I want to sell white shirts to cricketers? Do I want to sell white shirts only to people who are getting married for that particular day? And they will pay me 20,000 rupees a shirt. White shirt is a white shirt. There will be slight differences in the cost. But I cannot say I also make white shirts for people who are getting married and for students in Kendra Vidyalayas and for the army. Nobody can do that. Right? These are different customer segments. You will learn that in your marketing. Each segment has a separate value. The reason they buy something is different from the reason somebody else buys it. Right? The reason somebody buys a certain car, an SUV, etc., etc., it's all different. Why am I talking about that in the perspective of HR? Who is going to understand this value? Some human being in your team. So HR needs to motivate that person. Or stop demotivating him from actually listening carefully to the customer. The biggest lesson, if there is any in business, is to understand the customer. Everybody tries to do the same thing, right? Every car company has a designer, has millions of researchers. Why does every car look different? Because every team's understanding of what the passenger wants, what the customer of a car wants, is different, right? Because there are people in those teams in Maruti. Why is Maruti still at 50% market share after so many years? Does nobody else know how to make small cars? Of course they do. Nobody knows what a perfect small car is as much as Maruti does. No Why? Because some people in Maruti have become such perfect readers of the consumer's mind in India that they are unbeatable. Why? Because the human resource manager, director, their leader, the CEO, the chairman of the board has allowed those people to become such people. Has given them the opportunities to do that, has had a vision that I want to understand the consumer, has had a vision that I want to make perfectly something that is for the Indian market, at the Indian market price. And when those boys came down to back to him and said, sir, we have bad news. Our competition is selling cheaper. The CEO always has a choice saying, hey, so it happened to Guyong, I mentioned a competitor. Very good friend of mine, Uttaji. When he was bigger than us, we managed to buy out their company. And so one day over a drink, I said, do you know why is it that this transaction went the other way? It could have easily gone, you could have been buying out my company. So I was curious, I said, I want to know from you, sir, how do you feel about this? But he said, oh, I'm not interested, it's not making any money. So I said, do you realize, but I'm buying it because I think it's making a lot of money. Otherwise, why would I buy something which is losing money? Why is it that one businessman who's senior to me, who's much more money than me, has a much bigger factory than mine, was a public listed company? Things that there is no future in that business, and I think there's a lot of future in that business. Because he had a very smart general manager marketing. I spoke to the general manager marketing and said, what's going on in your company? He said, sir, I'm completely fed. If you have a job, I'll come to you. In the first meeting, why? He said, sir, I go to the market and I come back with news to my boss and I say, sir, market is bahut bura aa raha hai, the competition has dropped the price, Korean capacitors are coming in cheaper. Then he fires me. He says, tumhara kaam kya hai? You just come back and report to me and give you all the bad news. You are a manager. I pay you a lot of money. Go and deal with the bad news. Aur agar sasta karke bechna hai, toh phir tumhari kya zarurat hai? Koi bhi bech sakta hai. Now that is the HR orientation of one business manager. Compared to me, who is an employee? Who's selling cheaper than us? Can you please bring some of those capacitors? Can we do some product differentiation? And I went to my team and said, hey, if these Koreans can do this, why can't we Indians do this? Let me show you the picture of some Koreans, let me show you the picture of some Indians. We have a huge history. We invented zero, right? We know how the, we are the ones who thought of the solar system. So now you're telling me we can't make a good capacitor and the Koreans can? So the question was, do I lead a team as a leader who says at the Kargil war, there's a cliff, people are all sitting on the top, the Pakistanis are shooting at us, and I can be a major lieutenant colonel in that team. And tell my guys, let me give you a very realistic situation. Tomorrow morning, at the crack of dawn at 5 o'clock, we will try and climb this hill. Enemy has great advantage over us. They're sitting right there, they can watch us. They have the best guns in the world. The Chinese will supplied them. And they will shoot at us. But we have no choice, we will still try to climb because those are the orders from the boss. And by the evening tomorrow, 50-60% of us will be dead. So say goodbye to each other. Call your families and say, your wife, your widow. But this could be a lecture. But this is a lecture, however terrible it sounds, that many business managers are giving their teams every day as we speak. It's realistic. Or then there is a guy saying, gives them a higher purpose. Saying, it's not about your and my life. It's not about our wives. It's not about our kids. It's about those millions of people, Indians, who think that we will save them. It's their belief, it's their hope. So while we need to be very careful, we have lost some territory. It's going to be a very, very dangerous mission. But this is exactly what we were trained for. This is what we were born for. Let's go and get our victory. And some 50% people died. But then they die as martyrs, not as cowards. Now that difference is the difference that HR can create in a team. What is the big purpose that we are going for? If the purpose is make more capacitors so that I get richer and I will buy a bigger car and a bigger house and you will remain the scum of the earth, you will continue to live in the slums that you live in. If that is the language that we are sharing, then they will not be motivated. And then like Guyong, the Rushas and many other companies, they will sell or they will get out of it. So creating that higher purpose, giving them with empathy, understanding what is it that brings them to work every day. How can I make it more interesting? I cannot change your job of looking at good and bad capacitors, but while looking at that good and bad capacitors, you have a prayer in the morning. I give you a suggestion scheme. We have a suggestion scheme. Every day people can make suggestions. until Friday to their own HOD. The HOD then looks at it. On Friday afternoon, a team of workers supervised by one manager sits together. That team is also voluntary and they decide if suggestions are good or not. All the good suggestions on the Saturday prayer meeting get 50 rupees each. So there are employees who earn 12,000 rupees a salary and 10,000 rupees out of suggestions. And those suggestions are what? They're just saying what can be improved in their workplace. That's how you make them an owner. What benefits do I have as an owner? That I can say what I have to say, I can implement ideas that I have to do, I can. But when the losses are there, they're also my losses. So I give them a pedestal which is better than an owner. Only the profits are yours. All the good ideas are yours. The bad ones, when they happen, I will take the fall. And what better relationship can you develop? While this is all very nice, you asked a question about IR. Are all people good? Are all they following this? Let me give you a very interesting example of. Let me give you two examples. The other thing is that as owners, we also get to speak to people like this. So we decided to also share that work. So every day at the bread, there is a talk given by one of the workers. So there is a roster put up in our notice board, and you will know whose turn it is tomorrow to speak. So one of these days, this is one of my stories that I repeat quite often because I find it so fascinating. Veerpal lands up at my office. Veerpal is our Safai Karamchari. Right? He is a part of the housekeeping team, never went to school. And he's somebody I inherited. When I took over the company, Veerpal was already there. He's one of the first party people. So Veerpal is looking very, very pale. I'm very scared to talk to him. So I said, kya ho gaya? He says, sab aap se baat kar rahe hain. Sab logon ne mujhe bataya ki mera naam notice board pe likha hai. Kiske likha hai? Sab wo bol rahe hain ki kal mujhe baat kar rahe hain. Kahan baat kar rahe hain? Sab prayer mein mujhe kal baat kar rahe hain. जरूर बात कीजिए आप. तो मैं तो बात नहीं कर सकता. क्यों नहीं कर सकते? आप मेरे से तो बात कर रहे हैं. नहीं साहब, एक आदमी से चार आदमी से बात करना ठीक है, बट वहाँ तो 400 लोग हैं, कैसे बात करेंगे? मैंने कहा आप आगे जो चार खड़े हैं उनसे बात करना, बाकी को छोड़ो. सो ही सर, मैं नहीं कर सकता. मैं तो HR मैनेजर के पास भी गया था. मौर्य जी ने बोला कि नहीं, ये एग्जामिनेशन वो नहीं दे सकते, तो आप ही दे सकते हैं. तो मैं आपके पास आया हूँ, मैं बात नहीं कर पाऊंगा. मैं तो कराऊंगा ही नहीं नौकरी. Explain to him why it is that we do this exercise, why it is your chance to speak. I tried my best. And I said, look, but the first time I spoke in public, I was also nervous. It's nothing new. So what I can do for you is that I will come and stand next to you. You know, I will help you. I will prompt you wherever you falter. But we are going to do this together. So this guy went up obviously very, he wasn't very convinced, let's say. Next morning, I was very curious what Veerpal is going to do. So Veerpal came and he was a little confident, but obviously half confident. And he started a speech. And he said, "Main kal raat so nahi paya, kyunki mujhe bada dar lag raha tha ki main aapse kya bolun, samne bola bolna hai. To fir main sochta raha raat mein ki mera kaam kya hai. Kaha ki mujhe log kehte hain safai karmchari. To mera kaam hai saaf karna. Kya saaf karna? वो जो आप लोग गलत है. तो फिर मुझे लगा कि आप लोगों से अगर मैं आज कहूं कि यार थोड़ा गंदा कम करो तो मेरा काम कम हो जाएगा, तो इससे बढ़िया मौका क्या मिल सकता है. इसे मुझे कभी कभी लगता है कि आप लोग तो बहुत बड़े लिखे हैं, आप तो इंजीनियर बन गए हैं. कंपनी ने आपको ऐसी मशीन दी है 25 लाख रुपये, 30 लाख रुपये की एक मशीन. इतने की तो मशीन गाड़ी नहीं आती, लेकिन आप उस मशीन को इतनी बुरी तरह से रखते हैं कि मुझे लगता है आपसे तो अच्छा मैं कम से कम मैं तो प्रोडक्ट को साफ रखता हूँ. आई एम नॉट एग्जैजरेटिंग, आई मीन नॉट एग्जैक्टली इन दिस वर्ड्स, बट दिस इज व्हाट द सम एंड सब्सटेंस ऑफ व्हाट ही वाज सेइंग वाज. एवरीबॉडी इन दैट हॉल वाज वेट आईड. द काइंड ऑफ कंपैशन दे बिगन टू हैव, वी हैड नेवर रियलाइज्ड दैट दिस पर्सन हैड सो मेनी फीलिंग्स. वी हैड नेवर अलाउड हिम टू स्पीक टू अस. दैट मुन्ना भाई सीन ऑफ going and hugging the guy, I didn't go and hug him. But it was happening to us. Because you suddenly realize, hey, this guy is equally responsible for building this company. We are a 5S company. Every customer who buys a capacitor doesn't buy it without looking at a company, whether it's a Denso or Philips, a Panasonic, a Siemens, a Samsung. They will not buy it till they've not seen an effect. Somebody keeps this room clean every day, right? And we would not have the same education, the same, everybody would come and talk of quality here and imagine that there was a lot of dirt lying around and cobwebs all over. Would you still get the same understanding of quality? You won't. So that person is also a teacher in our journey of quality, of excellence, of perfection. But we don't acknowledge that because we don't give them a time to speak. I think the bargain I'm getting out of these people, that I'm a very shrewd businessman. Because I hire the guy as a housekeeping guy, but I make him a motivational speaker. The same 10,000 rupee guy, everybody else is only using him to sweep the floor. I'm getting him to build a world-class company. So it's really up to us. It is up to us and our HR thinking. So you will learn a lot in HR, I'm sure. Systems and processes. But I think at the core of that, the fundamental thing that we need to understand is that our job is to make that a nice playground. Where people come pumping with energy. In my neighborhood, when it's time for kids to play at 5:36 in the evening, even a kid with fever who's not gone to school in the day lands up there. If he can't play, at least wants to sit and watch what is going on. Can we make our organizations that? By doing that, there will be some people who will not follow the rules to answer your questions. So we had another weird call, but this time a negative weird call. Very smart guy. Young diploma engineer called, he was actually not diploma, like IKEA, Suryanarayan Gupta. Suryanarayan was a pain in the backside. Wherever you put him, this guy was, he was very intelligent, of course. So most people who are like that, even in the classroom who can't sit quiet, are the ones who are obviously sharper than the rest of us, but lacks the discipline. So whichever department this guy went to, he would either get into a skirmish, do something stupid, deliberately create some problems, seeking attention all the time. And everybody who took him, the supervisor, said, look, please fire this guy. I can't handle him anymore, I tried, you know. And so he was escalated to the best manager. Some other manager would take a challenge. And one of the philosophies we have in our company is we don't fire people at all. Because we had an agreement to hire you, let's have an agreement that you don't want to work with us anymore. Why should we have a disagreement about this? And you can do that. In 640 people, we've done that. So Suryanarayan was a good case in this case. So every time this came up, I asked the other HODs, hey, anybody else wants to take the challenge? And somebody would say, yeah, I want to do that. And a year later, he would also come back saying, I took up a wrong challenge, this guy is really incorrigible. So finally, everybody was fed up and this guy was given up a job to be a vendor development guy. His job was to be out of the factory, take a scooter, go pick up small spare parts and bring it to people in time. Because if this was held up, then the bosses would know and they would take care of him. So that was the idea, keep him under a very, very tight leash. But of course, he did a very good job. Spare parts were coming, quality was improving, all that is not a problem. Because he is a good worker. But he had this problem. So, sure enough, we got a complaint from one of the suppliers saying, it has never happened, sir, with DEKI, but this person asked me for money, for a bribe. And so I said, so what did you do? On the phone, this guy says, I gave him a check because I didn't have cash. So I said, did he encash the check? He said, yes, he encashed the check. Can you come to me tomorrow with the bank statement? He said, yes, I will. Because I know that your company doesn't allow this at all, so I'm really so sure. Thank you very much for helping us out. Please come and meet me tomorrow. Now, while we're waiting for the vendor tomorrow, everything changes in the next few hours, as you know, in these companies. This word spread, somebody got to know, etc., etc., etc. The vendor called me up in the evening saying, sir, body galti ho gayi. Usse bribe nahi maara tha, uska bachcha bimaar tha, maine uska hospital ka paisa diya tha. He made a big story. And this whole story was completely diluted. There was no way I could prove that he had taken a bribe. A vendor was willing, not willing to, so we even put pressure. We said, you lose this whole order if you don't do this right. But he said, they said, he frankly did not ask very. So he took the whole thing on his own. And we said, okay, how do we deal with something like this? Because now everybody knows, and if this guy is allowed to get away with asking for a bribe, so we have, behind my business card, you will see, and we have a small bonsai in our company. Look at our website, it's there. A bonsai made of capacitors. It's just an artist's rendition of a small, nice looking bonsai. Capacitors are small things, come in different colors, so it's a very nice looking thing. But I always use that as an employee saying, DEKI is like a bonsai. We are small, yet complex. Which means for a customer, all the fruits he wants, all the types of capacitors they want, is available in one cup. We are not a Panasonic, we are not a Philips, we are not a Siemens. But we will give you exactly those and more capacitors. So that is our message to the customer through the bonsai. But every tree and branch, is shaped and pruned. Because the bonsai master has an idea of what this bonsai should look like. That is the beauty of a bonsai. A Japanese guy who works on it for 20 years makes that tree. He has an idea from the day it is a sapling. What will this tree look like? As your professor, this college has an idea. What will you look like when you become manager? 10 years, 20 years down the line, you'll be a director HR somewhere or CEO somewhere. What should you look like? What should your feelings be? How should you feel about HR? And that's why they invite someone like me. And I hopefully do a reasonable job. So that bonsai, so I took the bonsai out. I put a notice saying, everybody knows that there has been an incident with Surya Narayan. I would like to discuss this with anybody who's interested in the conference hall tomorrow at 8 o'clock. So everybody is surprised why they've been called. And this is not managers, everybody at large. So some 40 people come into the conference room and they said, sir, yes, what can we do kind of thing. So I said, you know what happened to Surya Narayan? We don't have proof. Quite frankly, I'm not now 100% sure that he took a break. I think 95%, 98% I'm sure. But I want you guys to decide. So how would we decide? Here's the one side. In my opinion, one of the branches has got a weed, or has got an insect, and that insect is eating away at that branch. If we don't do something about it, it can get the whole tree someday. So my suggestion as the CEO is we chop this branch off. We let it go. But because you are as much bonsai master as I am, it's not only my company, it's your company too. You guys decide. For a change, I'm going to walk out of the room, I'll come back half an hour later, tell you what you decide. So obviously they were in shock because no management gives you this kind of an authority. But that is how ownership is built. We walked out and I came back, they said, sir, we discussed this. You're absolutely right. We are 100% sure you could go back. But he had these three kids or whatever, and he just had a young newborn. At this stage, if he loses his job, he has written to the street. So if it is okay, can we give him one chance? You guys give him the chance. Don't tell him I gave him the chance. You go and tell him you gave him the chance. Because next time this happens, you are the ones who will take that chance away, not me. Story was over. A few months later, this guy won't stop, obviously. Then we put him in a store, we said, let him not go outside and meet other people, let him be inside. His job was to get some material from the store, take it to another department. And there was an old lady worker of ours. This lady came crying to me, saying I was in the store along with this guy and he came and pinched my bottom. And he has done this before, I never complained, but this is enough. And you guys talk about sexual harassment, I will not take it anymore. I said, sure, please write it down on a piece of paper and we will make a police complaint. And strictest action will be taken as the law. She said, no, that's exactly why I come to you. This I know. This is my right. Because we educate them on sexual harassment. We put posters everywhere. We got in people from outside. Talk to our lady employees. What are their rights? Because we take this seriously. In fact, more than me, our chairman, Mr. Jaykumar, is extremely serious about this. So we had done all this. So she knew our rights. She said, but my problem, sir, is that I forget giving it in writing. I cannot even verbally say this outside this room because my husband thinks that the only reason I come to work is to flirt with these boys. He has a very bad judgment of my character. And he will be very happy to use this as an excuse. He doesn't need money. She was a worker in the store. But she says, this job gives me dignity. I get out every morning, I get ready and I come out of it. And I don't want to be with my mother-in-law and she had her own problems. So please don't take away this job from me. I've done nothing wrong. The guy has done something wrong. And you are going to take away my job as a result. So you need to find an answer, but I want to stay on, but I want this guy punished. That's a very tricky thing to do with HR. Okay. So we put a notice board again saying there has been an incident. I cannot even blame Surya Narayan now. I cannot even say what the incident is because I promised the lady I would let it out. I want to discuss this at 3 p.m. today in the conference room. But before that, those 30, 40 people or whatever number came into my room. Came there and said, sir, no 3 o'clock meeting is required. This guy has done the wrong thing. You know exactly what you're talking about. And he is willing to resign right now. He has owned up to his mistake. He's willing to apologize to the lady. And he has to be thrown out. And finally, this guy resigned and he went off. The rules. A couple of years later, this guy called me. He was obviously had a drink too many later in the night. And he said, sir, I called to apologize. You are on the Dubai account. Or my supervisor will be on the construction site.
और यहाँ 20 लोग मेरे साथ काम करते हैं, बट मैंने आपको फोन इतना लेट इसलिए किया होगा तो आप दिल्ली आए तो मुझे हिम्मत नहीं थी आपसे बात करने कि आपने जो मुझे सिखाया अब मैं 20 लोगों को सिखा। जी सर, थैंक यू फॉर मेकिंग यू वट आई एम, आई हैव रिफॉर्म्ड वट एवर वर्ड्स ही यूज्ड। सो एन आईआर इशू इज एन आईआर इशू बिकॉज वी हैंडल इट बेटर, इट इज अ मिसअलाइनमेंट ऑफ आवर पर्पसेस। If we align these purposes, why should there be any disagreement? So why should I fire somebody? Why should I terminate anybody? You don't need the job anymore, my friend. Right? You want to go somewhere else. We are not able to meet with your aspirations. Someone else is able to meet. Tell me, how can I help you to meet your aspirations? Do you want me to make a call to the other employer and say, he's a good employer? I'll do that, if you are a good employer. I will set up an interview for some time. I'll tell you to go to my friend. But why are we continuing in a relationship if you don't like what I do, and I don't like what you do? We are not the only company in the world. Go somewhere else, I will find another job. So if you have that kind of a discussion, then there is no IR. In my opinion, you don't need those procedures in this process. In the same light, we tell people now, some of you are smart, why are you only making capacitors? So we made a P2C thing called Zero Moss. You can put in a room like this and it will suck in all the mosquitoes. And that's something just on Amazon just now. That's our first B2C product, designed by three simple interns who came to us. We gave them an idea. But I think, so what we are trying to create in DEKI is a platform where you will come, and I call it an incubating platform. Come with ideas, come with the energy, learn to work in teams, learn to deal with disputes. Yeah, I just met another professor in the breakfast room who's writing a book on happiness. And I follow a Buddhist practice, and I must share that with you. Where, quite fantastically, as I said, happiness is not the absence of disease or absence of accidents or the absence of things that we don't want to happen in our lives. Yeah. It's not the absence of suffering. Everybody in life will have some suffering. People who know how to deal with that suffering with dignity will always be happy. So you train a team to deal with their disputes, to deal with their issues. Every day is a disputed business. Somebody else wants to sell cheaper, better. Somebody says, you're not right. Somebody wants to make a duplicate capacitor, name it DEKI. All sorts of things will happen. Customers want to lie to you. People don't want to pay you on time. People have ordered and said, oh, I made a mistake. I'm not going to take these capacitors. It's going to happen every day. Their design is wrong. You give the right capacitor. Their equipment failed. They want to blame you for it. These are things that will always happen. But creating a team that can deal with this in a very humane way, in my opinion, is the answer. So to me, HR is not human resource. It's a humane relationship. Deal with people like human beings. Point them to the people say, if you treat them like human beings, then they will not get to the goal. No, on the contrary, show them the scoreboard. Share the scoreboard with them. Share the excitement and the depression with them. And then you're not a team anymore. You become a family. That's what we call ourselves. I hope it's been a good morning for you guys. Yeah. Questions? I'll stop there. We can go on with these stories.
So you told us.